What's up, guys? We're here in Las Vegas, Nevada at Town Square, AMC Theaters.
Yes.
How are you, Chasing Cinema?
Good, how are you, James Shoup?
Good, we're excited. It's Thursday, and yes. We have the prequel.
Prequel to The Wizard of Oz. It's been nearly 75 years since audience went to Oz. 75. Well, 74, but we'll just round it up. I'm excited for this movie somewhat. I know last week we were saying we weren't too hyped up, but I kind of got myself a little bit in excitement mode. James Franco hasn't done a serious big picture since Rise of the Planet of the Apes, so I'm glad he's returning to the screen.
Which is a great film.
I hope Disney really enhances this movie, kind of brings back the magic that Oz has, because, you know, The Wizard of Oz is powerful because it's the literally epitome of movie magic. So I hope this movie keeps it going.
All right, well, technology has grown a little bit.
Yeah, so they definitely need to use that to their advantage.
All right, so we'll be back in, what, about 2 hours?
2 hours, 2 hours, 10 minutes.
About 2 hours and 10 minutes, and we'll see how the movie was. So we just got out of Oz, the Great and Powerful.
Yes.
James Franco.
Yes, James Franco, Mila Kunis. I don't think this movie was a performance movie at all. None of the performance really stood out to me, not even Mila Kunis, who did amazing in Black Swan. The problem with Oz the Great and Powerful was a good movie, okay movie, but it couldn't stand its own 2 feet. It's fun for this nostalgia factor. We get to go back, we get to see a lot of inside things that people who loved Wizard of Oz would appreciate. However, just because you paint a brick road yellow and you make Emerald City doesn't mean you create the magic of Oz. Oz is a very powerful feeling and it's had 75 years to grow on us. This movie I don't think will last a decade. I think it was okay, but it didn't have enough to stand its own 2 feet, which really lets it down.
There was a lot of little cookies inside the movie.
Yeah, there were a lot of cookies, which were cool at times, and I think that's why it made it interesting. The story of how it all came to be was quite interesting, but I don't think the movie was powerful enough or really went on the magic. I think it just really rode on the coattails of the Oz story.
Okay, so if everybody wants a full-on review, buy Chasing Cinema, go to ChasingCinema.com.
Yes.
Find him on Facebook, follow him on Twitter.
Yes, and then come back next week on Thursday to see...
It's a great
question. I know it. It is... I don't know. The Call, Halle Berry.
And I'm excited about that.
Yes.
And I know you're really not.
I'm gonna be okay.
But it's another week.
Yes.
And it's what we do.
Absolutely.
So if you've never seen any of our stuff before, rate, comment, like, subscribe, find us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter. If you've never liked it, if you really liked it, push favorite, that'd be cool too. And until the next episode,
see you next week.
We'll talk to everybody soon.